Good afternoon, everyone. Hello. I'm Dr. Priti Shenai, consulting clinical dermatologist and cosmetologist at Skinworks Clinic. We are based in Juhu. Let me talk about myself and my clinic. At Skinworks, we offer a comprehensive and holistic solution to all skin and cosmetic related conditions. We offer treatments for skin, hair, and nails. We are based in Juhu, and in skin, we have a battery of treatments for hyperpigmentation, for aging, and for skin glow. So in hyperpigmentation, we have treatments like microdermabrasion, chemical peels, laser toning. In anti-aging section, we have Botox, fillers, platelet rich plasma for skin rejuvenation, mesobotox. And in hair care, we have treatments for hair loss, hair regrowth, for thinning, where we offer laser light diode, platelet-rich plasma, and mesotherapy and cyclical therapy. I have an extremely trained personal staff which takes good care of patients and offers safety and hygiene standards are maintained. Skin treatments are offered depending upon I take a complete detailed history of the patient to understand the need, and accordingly the treatment is being advised. I'm here to answer your questions, so please pen down your questions and let's start the session. Okay, until the sessions are coming, let's talk about, we are here to discuss skincare and hair care in winter. So winters have come in. Today we see in Mumbai that we are having varied seasons. We cannot predict actually when what kind of a season we are facing. So we had rains until the mid of October, and now the winter has slowly started setting. So the most important thing that we have to consider is every skin responds differently in different seasons. So even a person who will have an oily skin may notice to feel dry during winter. So we have to hydrate ourselves well. Try and take good amount of fluid every day. Our skin and hair will lack moisture. So try and hydrate your skin. We need to use cleansers which have pH base balanced, and they are not very, they don't have too much of, they're so free and they do not have too much of alcohol in them. So use basic mild cleansers, which will and wash your face at least twice a day. Also, though we feel that, you know, we are not, the most myth about people are that they are not exposed to sun and they don't need a sunscreen. But sunscreen is the most important skincare that you need to adapt in any weather. May it be rain, summer, winter. So in winter also you have to use your sunscreen. So please use a broad-based sunscreen which protects you from UVA and UVB, and use the sunscreen at least once in the morning, 20 minutes before you step out for your work, and again reapply after 4 hours. Even people who are indoors need to apply sunscreen, okay? And use, in case, most of the sunscreens today have a lot of moisturizers in it, and hence you don't need to use a special moisturizer. But people, as I said, we are in winters now and our skin may feel a little bit parched. So hence we need to moisturize our skin even before applying the sunscreen. So sunscreen should be your last layer before you leave out for your work or you're going out. Also, before you sleep, try and cleanse yourself once and then apply a moisturizer. And use the moisturizer well. Also, we need to take care of our hands and feet, which definitely go very dry during winters. In other season, we can get away with it because we do not need to use it. But during winters, they definitely feel very dry. So when you are bathing, try and see that you do not have very hot water baths or very cold water baths. Try and take a tepid or a lukewarm water. But and then immediately post bathing, you should be applying a moisturizer very generously all over your body. Also, reapply your moisturizer before you go to bed. So for body moisturizers, I don't have any disclaimer for any product, but I would like to share some of the names, like, you know, Cetaphil or Sebamed moisturizers can be used. Okay. So here we've started getting some questions. There is Safiya Dawood who's asking me, where is this clinic? My clinic is based in Juhu. Second question is from Sachin Salvi. Dear ma'am, my son has severe atopic skin. He prefers more of lotion compared to cream, but now in winters with lotion, skin gets dry very frequently. Please guide on this. So Sachin, I don't know the age of your son, but yes, in skin in winters, patients who have atopic eczema or dry skin, they will have severe more dry skin, and hence you should be using creams which are mainly meant for atopic skin, and they need to be very deep moisturizing one. Lotions will not be able to serve the purpose, and he needs to reapply this cream at least 3 times in a day, morning, afternoon and night, because if the skin gets dry, he will feel more itchy. I hope he has no, if it is not helping, then please try and see a dermatologist. Bipasha Chakraborty, good afternoon, ma'am. My baby has an atopic skin. What care do I need to take? So Bipasha, I don't know the age of your baby, but kindly see that you use, don't give him too hot water bath, as I explained to you. Don't massage too much. I mean, if you're using an oil, just use it for maybe like for 10-15 minutes. Don't do too much of deep massage oil. And after bathing, just pat dry his body and immediately apply a moisturizer. Okay, which is for like a baby moisturizer. And again, reapply the moisturizer at night. Next question, madam, can you please suggest any good skin lightener for skin tan, Vaseem? Mr. Vaseem, first and foremost, skin tanning occurs because of many reasons. One is obviously excessive sun exposure. Also can be because of, now in winters, if our skin dries, that itself can look like a little more pigmented. Okay, Indian skin is more pigmented. So hence, try and see to it that you use your sunscreen, okay, at least twice a day between, say, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. And you can use a skin lightening moisturizer at night, which contains kojic acid, licorice, arbutin, or even a vitamin C cream can work well. Srinivas, what is common skin ailment that you find customers want to treat in the winter months? The common skin ailments are mainly dry skin, dry scalp, itchy scalp, hair. The hair becomes very dry and frizzy. In skin types, they have most of them who have sensitive skin may have flaking of the skin. They can have dry patches on the skin. People come with dry feet, cracked feet. They complain of hands going very dry. Some have peeling of the palms, which is called as keratosis. So there are many different conditions that we can see. And some also do get some kind of allergies. Next question is Sachin Salvi. I think I've answered your question. Saifa Nazir, how should we take care of hair in winter? So the hair goes a little dry. And some if the hair is only dry, then you should be using a very balanced, pH balanced shampoo. Okay, sulfate free, and also you should be using a moisturizer. Okay, you can also use an oil like just half an hour prior to washing your hair. Do not use oil more often or overnight. Just use it like half an hour, an hour before you have to shower your hair. But please use a moisturizer immediately. And those who have, sometimes you may develop dandruff or dry because the scalp lacks moisture. So there will be dryness and there will be flaking and itching. So hence you should be using, if there is dandruff, use an anti-dandruff shampoo at least once a week. Next, Hamsa, ma'am, please tell me which baby cream and soap is good for a baby of 1.5 years during winter. There are many, if it's for a general body, Hamsa, you can use baby care range of, as you're asking for a product, and I'm not supposed to mention the names, but still, if you could use the Cetaphil baby care range or the Sebamed baby care range, which is good. Sujata, why is dry skin more of a problem in winter? Because in winter, obviously, there lacks moisture in the air, and hence, even the skin starts depleting its own moisture, and that is why there is dryness. Dipesh, what would you recommend for open pores? So Dipesh, open pores basically happens in it is one of the sign of aging also. So in terms of open pores, that you can use certain medicated creams at night, like which contain retinoic acid to close the pores. But also there, it depends upon what the level of the pores are. So you may have to go and see a dermatologist to seek some help in terms of treatments. Like there are lasers that can be done for open pores. Next question, Karishma. I have dry skin and in winters it becomes more of itchy type. Why is it so? So Karishma, what I understand from your skin is that you may have a sensitive skin. So it's very important to understand what kind of cleanser or what kind of daily moisturizer you're using. Okay. If you're not using any, if you're just cleansing your skin too often, also can deplete the regular moisture of your skin. And if you're not using a moisturizer, obviously your skin will get dry and it can get itchy. So you need, again, repeating, saying the same thing again, that in, and if it is sensory, and if there is anything that is most sensitive, like if your skin is getting red or it's getting flaky, then you need to go and see a dermatologist. Maybe you need some kind of a medical therapy too. But on the conservative line of treatment, kindly see that you use a creamy based cleanser if you don't have an oily, for a creamy based cleanser, and also use a moisturizer. Jeannie Mathai, dear doctor, why do I think I just missed that? Shilata Berry, why is dry and itchy skin that I took it? Harish, ma'am, I'm from Delhi. Harish, I'm from Delhi, facing high smog and pollution in the air. I'm concerned about going out for my skin and more about my little niece and nephews. They also tend to scratch their skin after every evening trip outside. So Harish, regarding obviously the Delhi climate is more dry, and because winters are very intense there as compared to what we see in Mumbai, I would advise you to kindly, if you're in the day, you should be using, if your skin is extremely dry, you would need to use a moisturizer as well as a sunscreen before you leave. And if it is, and for your little ones, you definitely need to moisturize their skin very well. If they are, you can also in the day, if they have to move out, the niece and nephew can use the baby range of skin of sunscreen. Yasmin, which shampoo is good for oily hair scalp? Yasmin, oily scalp means that your sebaceous gland, that is your oil glands of the scalp, are hyper. So basically, you need to frequently wash your hair. So at least minimum 3 to 4 times in a day. So listen to your hair, listen to your skin, what it needs. And in terms of shampoo, you can use any normal shampoo, like but the cleansing of the scalp is more important. Vanshu, good afternoon. Can you please suggest any natural remedy for hair fall? My hair is silky and very thin. Vanshu, when you talk about hair fall, there are a lot of reasons for hair fall. A, the hair fall could be because of nutritional problem. It could be because of lacking proper care. It could be because of stress, erratic lifestyle, diet not being very good. So you need to know the cause of hair fall is very important. And regarding a natural remedy, I would suggest, I don't think anything naturally will definitely. One thing that you can improve is improve the protein in your diet. Have good amount of fruits, vegetables. If you're a vegetarian, you can increase the sprouts. Have a glass of milk. But if you're a non-vegetarian, please eat egg whites, chicken, protein. So protein is very important for hair fall. Next question, Unmar. Dear doctor, what's the best moisturizer for my skin type? Unmar, I don't know what your skin type is. So if you ask me, a general moisturizer would be, you could use the acetophyll moisturizer. Rakesh Yadav, dry skin and acne problem I'm facing. So Rakesh, you're talking about dry skin as well as acne problem. Now most of the patients feel that, you know, just because they have acne, that means they have oily skin. No, but there are people who have dry skin as well as acne. So for the acne, I don't know your age, but if usually acne happens in the pubertal age group, and even beyond that, if it stays, okay, that is beyond the age of 20, that means there's definitely something going wrong somewhere, and we need to find out the cause, whether it is because of your dietary habits, whether it is because of your stress levels, or is there some hormone fluctuation happening. So according to that, we will have to find the root cause. You cannot use you need to use products which are mainly for combination skin type, not oily or dry, because of the acne issue. Vivek Srivastav, please suggest some medicine for pseudopsoriasis. Srivastav, there is psoriasis or there is something called a sore eczema. I'm sorry, I wouldn't be able to just suggest some medicated treatment on live like this unless I see the patient and what the problem is. Gagan, ma'am, please suggest something for my under eye skin. So Gagan, as you've written for my under eye skin, I believe there may be some kind of under eye darkness which you're trying to ask me. Darkening around the eyes could be of many reasons. Again, there could be lack of sleep. There could be some kind of an iron deficiency, or there could be pigment which is occurring because of whether you have dry eyes or there is a hollowness that is happening. We usually see aging around the eyes as a first sign of aging in Indian skin. So you can use some skin lightening cream around the eyes, which will at least help to lighten the shade of the skin. You can use, as I said earlier, skin lightening things which includes vitamin C or kojic acid, licorice will help. And obviously, you should be using a sunscreen everywhere, even around the eyes. Vanshu, is it really possible to regain hair naturally? Vanshu, it is depends on the level of what the hair thinning or hair fall is. See, there are two different things. Hair thinning is basically where in men we see which we call as nail pattern hair loss, and if it's only hair fall, it could be just related to nutritional deficiency. So depending upon the state where it is, naturally would be just take care of your diet, exercise, have a good hour of sleep, increase the protein will help at least to bring in the reduce the fall a little and also to improve your hair growth. Mukta, I change my beauty product line up for my skin in the winter. Should I adjust my hair product routine too? Yes, Mukta, it depends upon how your hair is. Now, if your hair, ideally conditioners can be the same for any of the season. But in the shampoos, as I said earlier, if you have a dry itchy scalp, you may have to add an anti-dandruff shampoo. Or if kindly used a less pH, non-sulfate free shampoos, that will be good for all the seasons. Neha, my skin type is T, which moisturizer should I apply? My skin, you mean, Neha, you mean your skin type, like your skin type is T, means the T-zone is oily. So you can use a combination moisturizer, not specifically for oily skin or for dry skin. Karishma Survey, doctor, I'm fine artist. Some colors give me allergy. What will it really harm me as I have to be with colors all the time? Karishma, when you talk about some colors give me allergy, I mean, do they give you nasal allergies or do they give you skin face allergies? Try and see that you, in case if they give you any kind of fume, like if you're, some people when they inhale fumes of the colors can get some kind of an allergy, so try and wear a mask. See to it that you don't touch the colors when you're painting, don't touch the colors on your face. So that will help to avoid. And if it is severe, you may have to see your dermatologist to understand what the problem is and take the treatment accordingly. Question from Abdul Salam. Please suggest any skin lightener in winter. Abdul, the most important thing is, again, I repeat that you have to, dryness in the skin can increase the, can make your skin look darker. So use a good balanced cleanser. Also hydrate, moisturize your skin with a good skin lightening moisturizer which contains kojic acid, licorice, arbutin, and you use your sunscreen. So sunscreen, you have to use your sunscreen always throughout the day, at least till 6 p.m. And at night, again, use a skin lightening moisturizer as I've explained before. Question from Sumit, can you suggest some good essential oils? Sumit, regarding the essential oils, can you just elaborate your question a little more? What do you want to know more about the in regards to skin, in regards to hair? Next, Vinay Singh, ma'am, minoxidil can be helpful in hair fall. Vinay, minoxidil lotion can be helpful in hair fall, especially for when in male pattern hair loss. But yes, depending on, it can be started, but then once I'm in oxygen, you'd have to see a dermatologist to understand what is the level of hair thinning that you have and how much of and what is the strength that you need to use. Hello, Ashvika. How do I take care of my hair in winter, please? Ashvika, I have said this before that in terms of your hair in winter, you need to wash your hair at least minimum 3 times a week because we're exposed to too much of pollution, smoke, and there's a lot of grime that can accumulate onto our scalp. Kindly use, when patients ask me which is the best shampoo, there's no one best. You have to use a shampoo to understand what suits you best because there are a lot of factors that need to be considered. So try and use a sulfate-free shampoo, okay? And then moisture your hair pretty well. If you oil your hair at least once a week and only use it for an hour and then wash it off. Sachin, nowadays I've seen lots of procedures, people undergoing some kind of hair patch treatment and within some seconds, bald fellow becomes handsome and smart. But are these types of hair patch procedures really safe for scalp and long term? So Sachin, what I understand from your question is that you mean that patients are undergoing hair transplant. Yes, if you have a severe grade of male pattern hair loss or androgenetic alopecia, and if you want to see results faster, then obviously hair transplant can be done. And then you need to, it is definitely safe if you're doing it with a very specialized person. Ravindra, hello, I want to know how can I get rid of scalp itching and dandruff. So Ravindra, first and foremost, the scalp itching and dandruff, you would use anti-dandruff shampoo, okay, which are available. In case if that's not helping, then you would need to go and see a dermatologist to understand whether it is only dandruff or is there any kind of scalp eczema. Sujata, my skin is dry and breaking out at the same time. Okay, so Sujata, as I said earlier, that mostly acne patients also do feel dryness of the skin in this season. So hence, for the in this season particularly, when you're trying to treat both your dry skin and acne, you should be using a skin moisturizer for combination skin. And try, and usually the anti-acne creams, if you are using, which will contain some kind of benzoyl peroxide or adapterin, they will dry the skin too much. So hence, you may have to limit the contact time of your anti-acne cream to avoid the further drying of the skin. That will help to solve both your skin dryness as well as heal the acne. So as I was sharing, let's go back to the tips for winter. As I was sharing earlier that, you know, we try to neglect our hands and feet. So in winter, we definitely face a lot of problem of dry skin, cracked feet, and palms go very dry. So try and take soak your feet in a lukewarm water, and you can use a mild pumice stone to just rub the heels to remove all the dead skin, and then you can and apply a moisturizer sparingly. There are specific moisturizers which are available for hand and feet, which are more deep, intense moisturizing. And also take care of your nails, take care of your cuticles, because they are the ones which also, because of the dryness and wear and tear, you will see that your cuticle can rip off. And if the cuticle rips off, it can give rise to some of the fungal infection. And there could be cracking and, peeling of the skin that can happen. So most important in skin care, people usually ask me, doctor, how do I get a good glowing skin or a beautiful skin? It's basically, it's a holistic approach. We are all under pressure and stress all the time. I mean, today life demands a lot from us. So try and get an adequate 6 to 7 hours of sleep. Try and see to it that you take a balanced diet. Okay, at least minimum 5 to 6 days a week. One day you can cheat. But you should take your adequate protein in terms of milk. You should have at least 2 or 3 fruits daily. You should have salads, vegetables, sprouts. If you're a non-vegetarian, have chicken, fish. Also, try and do an exercise, at least cardio, for minimum 4 to 5 days in a week, because that will help to metabolize, increase your metabolism, also balance your hormones and not add stress to your skin. Because for skin, it's a holistic approach. And follow a minimum skincare regime, whichever season it may be, that you need to cleanse your skin, moisturize your skin, and use a sunscreen daily. That will help to give you a good balanced skin and will help you to take care. And obviously, if there's any major problem, you need to go and see your dermatologist for more help. I think we are just waiting for some more questions to pour in. So when patients, there's some people mostly ask us about hair fall, and the most important worry these days is, like, even I see hair thinning and hair fall, people complaining of hair fall even at the age, young boys and young girls. Okay, basically what the reason for we seeing, like, you know, boys are seeing thinning at 20 when their parents, their fathers have had balding at the age of maybe 40, 50. It's basically the stress that they are going through. And they are not taking care of their diet, they're not taking care of their exercise, and hence they have seen the thinning or receding hairline faster as compared to their parents. Today, none of us want, I mean, even if we have to walk a lane away, we don't want to walk it up. We have complete sedentary lifestyle, and taking care of our daily routine will help us to keep ourselves away from a lot of skin and hair and problems. But we only wake up when the problem arises. So hence, if you see I'm being repetitive, but yes, please start taking care of your, if you want a healthy skin, you want a healthy lifestyle, then you have to follow these parameters well. So there comes the question, ma'am, my hair is very thin, so what can I use for this? Vinay, when you're talking about your hair is very thin, means there is a sign of male pattern hair loss that has started. As such, you may need to take certain vitamins for hair, which will help to strengthen your hair root. You will need to apply certain lotions which will be helping to stimulate the hair growth and to strengthen your hair roots. So kindly go to a dermatologist and try and examine yourself and see what the problem is. And if you follow things, it will definitely, there is a chance for you to revive your hair back. Mostly patients, people ask, like, what are the different types of, how often one should be doing a facial, or it ideally these days, I mean, no offense to any of the salons or parlors, but working on the skin, you can go and take treatments of, like, medifacials in some of the nearby clinics, like skin clinics that are offering you, or maybe even salons and parlors today are offering these kind of medifacials, where there is exfoliation of the skin done by a machine-based device, and there is cleansing is done, and then there is introduction of serums into the skin by a machine, which helps to hydrate, improve your skin glow, and also gives you textural improvement. So these are the different things that can be done. And also talking about a little bit of I have a question by the people asking me, what about laser hair removal? How safe it is? And how early can one start? So laser hair removal is a device which helps to remove the hair growth. Yes, it can be done on any area of your body. It is targets the hair root. So hence, you will see that there will be reduction of the hair. The rate at which the hair growth is prolonged, the number of hair go down, and definitely it's a very safe and pain-free and easy option than to go and thread or wax or shave yourself. So here comes another question. Can you please tell me your remedy for stretch marks? So mainly stretch marks, that is by Kiran. Kiran, stretch marks could be because of weight gain. It could be because of weight loss also in some patients or in women because of pregnancy. So you can use anti-stretch mark creams which contain vitamin E. There are these silicone-based creams which are available, which will show you an improvement. And that you can also, depending upon the severity, because early the stretch marks are, then the stretch marks can be treated faster. But once they turn white and they are there for prolonged, the treatment takes a long time to show a response. And hence you may need to add for a faster recovery or to make the appearance of the stretch marks look better, you may need to go and see a dermatologist where they can use laser-based or energy-based devices like radio frequency or fractional lasers, which can help to reduce the stretch marks. But till then, you can start using a cream which contains vitamin E, silicone-based gels, which are used. Sachin Chaudhary, how to stop hair fall as well as grow the hair? Sachin, hair fall, the reasons are a lot. As I said, like that it could be a nutritional deficiency, it could be because of a local scalp dandruff, or it could be because of hormonal imbalance. Like in male, it is male pattern hair loss, and females, it could be female pattern hair loss. So if it is nutritional, then we have to give you need to take supplements which contain for vitamins, like vitamins for hair, which contain biotin, zinc, amino acids, minerals. And if there is a itchy scalp or there's dandruff, then we need to treat the dandruff first, for which can cause a little bit of hair fall. And that will be, we will have to, you will need to use an anti-dandruff shampoo. And obviously if it is thinning because of hormonal imbalance, then we need to give you hormones to improve the hair thinning, as well as that will help to and give you lotions, which will certain lotions which help in regrowth and stimulation of hair, like peptides, botanical extracts, and there are lotions like minoxidil which are given for hair thinning. Nitesh Gedia, ma'am, what is the treatment for white spots on face? So Nitesh Gedia, when you talk about when you're asking for white spots on face, there are different types. There are different white spots on the face. White spots could be because of many reasons. A, what is it? Is it a fungal infection? Is it a deficiency? Is it just a depigmenting skin problem like vitiligo? So one you would need to go and show a dermatologist to understand what is the cause of your white spots, and then accordingly take the treatment. Next question, Sri Ramula, what can I use to help improve my skin that is natural and good for my skin? Okay, so Shrivala just wants a basic general skin care. So Shrivala, use a sunscreen to continue to improve your natural skin, and also you can use skin creams which contain vitamin C, hyaluronic acid, which will help to enhance the skin glow and also maintain the moisture of your skin. Apart from that, take care of your diet. You have your greens, your juice, your fruits, your proteins, and take adequate sleep and exercise. Next question, Mahesh. What is the reason for sunburn? Mahesh, obviously sunburn is different than sun tan and different than skin pigmentation. So when you're talking about sunburn, means definitely you have been excessively, I mean, there has been someone stands is out in the sun for more than, in intense sun for more than maybe 6 to 8 hours, and they will see that their skin actually peels off. So that is basically because of severe exposure to sun. But there are some who complain of tanning, that is just that the skin color is getting hyperpigmented. So if you're out in the sun, you definitely need to use a higher SPF, more than, that is sun protection factor, more than 50, at least in our tropic country. And reapplied every 3 to 4 hours when you're out in the sun.
Karishma.
Yes. Karishma is waiting. Thank you, doctor. Karishma, dear doctor, is there any brand with sunscreen and skin whitener? So, Karishma, basically, when you're talking, there is, I cannot take the name of any brand, but there are, you can use, look for sunscreens these days which have skin lightening potential. So, when you mean by skin lightening, that works as a skin whitener, that is vitamin C. So, many sunscreens today in the market have vitamin C. Some of the sunscreens have even skin lightening agents like arbutin, licorice. They have tyrostat. These are the things which are available in the skin sunscreens today. So there are many international brands also which have specific sunscreens for hyperpigmentation like melasma, which they have their molecules in it, which work as both as a sunscreen as well as a skin lightener. So there's a question from Amjad. Can you suggest treatment for male pattern hair loss? Mr. Amjad, the treatment for male pattern hair loss is basically, you have to see a dermatologist to see what is the cause of your hair loss. I mean, your male pattern hair loss, and depending upon the grade. So there are treatments which are cyclical therapies given. Then you may need hormones as well as lotions like botanical extracts, peptides which contain peptides and minoxidil. Then, if the the promising results are seen with addition of platelet-rich plasma. And mesotherapy with laser light, which will help to regain your hair growth. So we have Sheetal Narkar. Ma'am, could you suggest a shampoo for itchy scalp during winters? Sheetal, for the shampoo for itchy scalp is an anti-dandruff shampoo. So you can use containing ketoconazole or zinc pyrothenone. These are the shampoos which you can use, which are medicated. And see to it that you wash your hair at least, shampoo your hair at least twice, so minimum twice a week, because of the dryness and the, there's a lot of grime and dust that can accumulate into the scalp and cause further itchiness. Fardeen Khan, doctor, is there any skin whitener and sunscreen available? I've taken this question. Ansari and Amar, always during winter my lips get much dry. Is there any way I can take care of it? So this is an excellent question, Aman Ansari. I was going to talk about this in a short while. Lips definitely go dry during winter. So when you are using your moisturizers, please try and apply it around the lips also. At night also you get lip balms which contain hyaluronic acid. There are specific ones these days available in the market. Some contain ceramides, which you can need to use frequently. Even when you're using your sunscreen, try and apply the sunscreen onto your lips to prevent it from getting hyperpigmented or dark. And Amar, when you're talking about if your lips are getting very dry, if they're peeling a lot, and if these moisturizers are not helping, then you may need to see a dermatologist. Maybe you're suffering from some, there may be some underlying skin eczema or a dermatitis that is occurring on the lips. Abhishek Raina, hello doctor, wanted to know best option for hair regrowth. Abhishek, the best option for hair regrowth is, there's no, I mean, you need to, as I've answered this question, but still I'll take it again, that if it is male pattern hair loss, you would need to use, you would need to undergo cyclical therapy, hormones which will stimulate the hair growth. You would need to use lotions containing minoxidil and peptides. Also, if it is, there are different stages of male pattern hair loss. So hence, you may need to add certain treatments like platelet-rich plasma, mesotherapy. But definitely, you have to see to it that you have a balanced diet, which contains high protein. Also, exercise well, sleep well. If you... cigarettes, if people are smoking cigarettes, they should avoid that because nicotine will increase the, delay the healing process, and that can also aid faster hair loss. Try and see whether there's any underlying vitamin deficiency like vitamin D3 or B12, because nowadays many of us are deficient in D3, and hence we need to supplement and take some hair vitamins. Samriddhi, is oily scalp a cause for hair fall? Can you suggest a mild shampoo for oily scalp? Samriddhi, oily scalp can lead to accumulation of grime and dandruff, which can cause itchiness, and that can lead to a minimal hair fall. Ideally, let me take it away and say this, that many people have a myth that, you know, when they talk about hair fall, our hair is definitely going to fall. Okay, it could be seasonal. Every day, minimum up to 50 to 60 strands of hair fall is a normal hair fall. Unless you see more than that, then that is a worry and you need to see a dermatologist. If you see that when you're getting up in the morning on your pillow, if you're seeing a lot of hair strands, it is not, then you need to worry. If it is more than, going up to more than 100. Patients complain that, you know, when I wash my hair, there will be hair fall. If your hair fall is around 50, 60 and you're seeing hair growth happening, then you do not need to worry. But if you're saying that your hair fall is there and thinning, and it is gradually thinning, and you don't see hair growth happening, then that is the time when you need to go and definitely address your problem to a dermatologist. Okay. So seasonal also, we'll see some amount of hair fall happening. Some people complain hair fall in winter. Some people will complain hair fall in summer. So everybody's response to the weather, to their daily lifestyle is different. So Mahesh, what is the treatment for dry skin? Mahesh, if general dryness which happens in winter, we'll just need a moisturizer. But if there is severe dryness, like atopic eczema, or that's called as dry skin, then that means you have sensitive skin and you need to, your products should be used well, right from your bathing products. So use a pH balanced shower gel. I tell patients with dry skin that they should use a pH balanced shower gel. Do not rub your skin too much. Generally use your hands. People use loofahs and bathing scrubs. Don't use those on your dry skin, on your skin. And pat dry your body and immediately lather your body with a moisturizer, like a deep intense moisturizer. And try and use medicated moisturizers, not very mild ones, because they have ceramides, they have other ingredients which give deep intense moisturizing. And also moisturize your body well at night. But if there is severe flaking of the skin, or if there is dryness and flaking of the skin, or there are, which can lead to severe itching, then it is some form of eczema, which where you will have to see a dermatologist to take help in terms of giving some medicated creams and ointments. Sachin, dear, once implanted, are these hair grafts as good as natural hair follicle? Yes, because Samriddhi, sorry. Sachin, the hair transplant, when you talk about hair transplant, they are your own hair follicles which are removed from one part area of your hair and they are then re-implanted into your area where the scalp is, there's no patch of hair. So they will look as natural as your hair because they are your own hair. But if you're talking about implants, they are different than transplanted hair. Those are synthetic fibers which are used for the hair thinning or to cover the bald patch. They may not look as natural as your hair. Shat, I'm traveling, it's very cold, I'm there. It's very cold there, what should I take care of? Shweta, yes, as our climate, if you're going to a very dry and a very cold climate, definitely your skin is going to start to feel very dry. So hence, you will need to use a product which is very deep moisturizing, like intense moisturizing, and try and use it every 3 to 4 hourly if your skin needs so. And if you're going to a very cold climate where you see the blast of air is too much, it may cause You can cover your face a little when you're out because the air breeze will be very cold and that can cause cracking of your lips, dryness of your face. So, but even if it is cold, as I said earlier, that sunscreen should never be forgotten as a part of your daily routine, whether it is cloudy, it is sunny, it is winter. Even if you're out in the out and there is no sun, some in some countries there may be sunset happening at 3 p.m., 4 p.m. also. But even if you're outdoors, kindly use your sunscreens because they not only protect you from the sun rays, but also they protect you from the pollution and atmospheric radiations. Karishma, dear doctor, can I use sebumet cream for long time? I'm finding it very effective. Karishma, as you have taken this question, yes, you can use sebumet cream. If it is helping you, there's no problem. Aishwarya, hello ma'am, I have oily skin. Please suggest some good cream. Aishwarya, if you have an oily skin, use a moisturizer, I mean, use a cream which has which is non-comedogenic, like that is oil-free. You can use creams which contains mild retinol, or creams like very mild potency of retinol, or something like a vitamin C cream or azelaic acid cream, which will help to restore the skin. Use a cleanser which contains salicylic acid, which will help to remove the oil from your skin. But yes, you must use a sunscreen that can be a matte based sunscreen. We have a lot of matte based tinted sunscreens available now in the market. They are also silicone based, which will not make your add more oil to your skin or make your skin look oily. Mostly oily skin patients, they refrain from using sunscreens because they feel that the skin gets very greasy, very oily, very grimy. So there are a lot of sunscreens which are available, which are matte based, and hence your compliance will be higher to use these sunscreens. Harish, my nephew is getting white patches on left hand side of the face. They come and go often for the past 1 year. We are worried if it's a very serious problem. So Harish, if it is coming on the one side of the face and they are coming and going, try, maybe it could be some kind of a fungal infection, okay, or it could be just a dry. It could be a condition called as P. alba, as your nephew is. I mean, sorry, I forgot to read that. Yes. How old is your nephew? Okay, not written how old is your nephew. But if he's a small boy, just see whether he has any kind of an allergic or an atopic tendency. They definitely get this condition called as P. alba, which are white patches which stay and they go off. But kind of moisturize your nephew well. And also, try and, because it's happening since past 1 year, I think you should seeking help from a dermatologist. If it is coming off on its own and going, I don't think it's a serious issue like a vitiligo or any other condition, but I would still recommend you to take an opinion of a dermatologist. Ajay Singh, ma'am, can I use sun lotion during winter? Yes, Ajay, you have to use a sunscreen in any season, may it be winter, monsoon or summer. And depending upon your activity outdoors, you should be using your sunscreen minimum 3 times in a day, but if not 3, at least twice, half an hour once before you step out, and again reapply after 3 to 4 hours. But even if you're at home, kindly use your sunscreen at least once a day. Neha, how do we get rid of dark circles? So Neha, when we talk about dark circles, there are many reasons for dark circles. A, it could be because of whether you have lack of sleep. Two is because of any deficiency. Iron deficiency can also lead to dark eyes, whether there is dryness around your eyes, so rubbing. And also sometimes we see hollowness that can begin at any age, which is gives a pseudo pigmentation around the eyes. In some women it could be because of hormonal changes, so we need to understand, and in most of them it could be because hereditary too. So we need to understand what the cause is and accordingly treat it. But giving you a simple remedy, you could just moisturize your skin with a skin lightening moisturizer and use a sunscreen to prevent further pigment darkening to happen. But kindly visit a doctor, a dermatologist, where you can get treatment for your dark circles. Stefan, hi doctor, I'm suffering from flaking of skin. What should I do? Stefan, that means your skin is very dry and sensitive. So you would need to use a very mild cleanser, like you can use a citrific cleanser to wash your face. But you need to hydrate your, moisturize your skin with a pH balanced moisturizer. And also try and, if this is not helping, then you may have some kind of, it could be a seborrheic flaking. If flaking is happening, that means there could be some kind of eczema, which is called a seborrheic dermatitis, which is commonly seen around your nose, your beard area, or your eyebrows. So if that is the case, you'll have to consult from a dermatologist. Abhishek, also, what will be a good shampoo for daily use as I ride a motorcycle and use a helmet? Abhishek, for as you're using a helmet every day, so definitely, and you're riding a bike, you're exposed to a lot of dust and pollution. But because of the helmet, at least your scalp is getting protected. So you can use a daily shampoo which is sulfate free. Obviously, try and use, as I said earlier, that not one single shampoo, not one product I can say is good. You will have to use, I may give you a battery of names, but you will have to try and see which one is good. But don't use too harsh shampoos, because you may need to wash your hair daily. And hence, but also add a mild use once a week at least an anti dandruff shampoo to get rid of any kind of oiliness or itchiness that can happen. Ansari, pH of skin products matter? Yes, the pH of skin products matter, because our skin pH is back. If you use a lot of high pH products, it can cause irritation, it can increase the sensitivity of the skin, especially in this weather, it can increase the dryness of the skin. So hence, used non-alcoholic, low pH, balanced pH-based products. Can we use extra shampoo regularly? Vinay Singh. Vinay, so let me talk about how one should wash your hair. The people usually have this myth, they will take a lot of shampoo and they will lather it around the, especially for in men, because they have their hair is shorter than women, so they just need to use the shampoo around the scalp and massage it for maybe 3 to 4 minutes and then rinse it off, and then they have to use a conditioner. But in women, they should only use the shampoo on the scalp and not on the entire length of the hair, because that will remove the natural moisture from this hair. And your hair you need to cleanse the scalp, because that is where the oil is produced. That is where your dust and grime gets accumulated. But on the length of your hair, one should use the deep conditioner to moisturize this hair. Karishma, my friend is a professional dancer and with lot of physical activity. She sweats a lot and has a bad odor. Is there any treatment for bad body odor? So Karishma, your friend needs to, if her main problem is first is that she sweats a lot and hence she has a bad odor. So for the sweating, there are certain lotions which can stop the sweating for 8 to 10 hours. So, which can be applied on the underarms, and that will stop the sweating, and that will also prevent the odor from getting bad. What is the best solution to stop hair falling? Srinivas, again, what is the best solution to stop hair falling? Srinivas, the best, first and foremostly, try and see what the cause of the hair fall is. So, maybe try and your nutritional help will, nutrition would help. Like take a good diet which contains iron, proteins. Okay. Use, if there is an itchy scalp, you can use an anti-dandruff shampoo. Maintain your active, do a physical exercise every day. A cardio exercise will help. See to it what is the fall count, as I explained before. If there is more than 50 to 100, then you need to see a dermatologist. But if it's up to 50, it could be just because of your stress levels or nutritional or seasonal. So that could be taken care by just as I explained before. Ravindra, Doc, I also want to ask how to get rid of dark spot on the face from pimples. Is there a natural way? So Ravindra, are you trying to fidget with your pimples in any way? Because that is called as acne exfoliate, that can leave these dark spots behind. And then they take a long time to go. Or some patients, in some people, the pimples itself heal with pigmentation. So in that case, you may need to use a skin lightening cream, which contains kojic acid, licorice, arbutin, vitamin C. And if they're very severe dark spots, then you may need to use some kind of hydroquinone and retinol-based creams to get rid of the dark spots. Kiran, the stretch marks question I've already taken before. Sachin, how to stop the hair fall as well as growth? I've already answered this question before. Hi, Ganesh, what is the cause of dandruff and dry scalp? I've already answered this question. Okay, so it was a nice interactive session and we will wind up here. In case we have missed out any questions, we will reply them on Facebook. Thanks for being a great audience and I hope I've been able to answer all your queries. This is bye from Dr. Priti Shenoy, Skinworks Clinic, Jubu. Thank you.